give you the... My mic is still off, I'll let you know when I did the introduction. Good afternoon and welcome to live streaming coverage of the 2013 Curl Atlantic Championship. My name is Gary Girt of CurlingZone.com. Joined in the booth by Al Ledgerwood, DI curling legend, five-time Briar representative, multiple coaching appearances as well. So Al's been on both sides of the glass, the Briar and Scotty's as well, correct? We've got a great final matchup here. We've got the women's final between Heather Smith-Dacey of Halifax, Nova Scotia, and Suzanne Birt of Summerside, Prince Edward Island, I believe. We're jumping into the first end here. The game has begun a few minutes early due to not needing to do the draw to the button. The blue stone has the hammer here in the first end. Again, started with the stone going in. Then Birt played a hit. Heather Smith-Dacey hit and rolled to the side. They changed the hit, and then Heather Smith-Dacey took the corner guard. So brothers, formerly Mauser, delivering the third stone to Team Smith-Dacey. Still got married over the summer. The Canadian junior champion. Still remember the year that Jill won it. Still been playing out of Ontario for the last 3 years and just moved back to Nova Scotia for the season. Picked up with a pretty good team. Good shot by Shelly Bradley. A couple of feet less weight would have been ideal. Looks like they can come to the nose of that, have a straight back, and then set up a two here. Yeah. Facing off against Peter Burgess. And it looks like Grattan has an open hit 4-2 here in the first end. Thank you. between the good piece of the 8 foot. Drop it on the floor and she'll guarantee herself 2 points here in the first. Now it comes. I'll probably take a quick look on the side. Looks like it's confirmed. Two. Good start for Heather Smith-Dacey and for Halifax. Four of them.
Hop off the thing is not there on both sides.
Likely to have that last shot in that first end. Smith-Dacey getting hammered in the first because of her record in the round robin. They finished 5-0. And last week's game, actually, between Heather Smith-Dacey and Suzanne Birt, they came out of the same pool and came down to the final end, and Heather Smith-Dacey's goal would be the extra. So Suzanne was second in the pool, and that's the result of the hammer in this game.
This is
Peter himself has made several Briar trips as well to Prince Edward Island. But, his son Brett and his other son, Chris, is off, Peter was saying, he's off curling in Manitoba this year, playing with Kyle Durant. It's kind of disappointing to see these young guys have to go away to kind of make a name for themselves. But in time, maybe Brett comes back to the island and skips his own team.
Well, we're rapidly becoming a
Carmody and Sheridan Rams will be in the pre trial. Carmody playing with Laura Crocker now, and Jerry Lynn with Crystal Webster's team. Both teams participating in this weekend's shootout in Edmonton, actually, and both reached the playoffs. And give you a little update on a little island update there. I know they were playing each other, I believe, in the quarterfinal. A little bit of a grudge match there, I imagine. Looks like Crystal Webster. So Jerry Lynn got that matchup. No, to be honest, I don't think there's any. The two teams between them are both excellent. Laura Crocker's team has a little bit of youth on their side. They're just out of university, and they play a lot on tour. And a very strong squad who qualified a bunch of times through the A-side in the past year. And then, of course, Crystal Webster added Catherine Clapham to her team, and a lot of experience in that lineup there. So, both of these have to do a big job. Interesting end. How close looks good for Smith-Dacey. So where the Rocks lie right now, I think it's the man. If they miss one or two really good shots, they're going to be able to do it pretty well. Yeah. Hit and roll inside, get the back one as well. Just don't. Thank you. hoping that they wouldn't just outright play the double in that spot. Just put the broom down in the middle, throw peel, and they'll both be gone.
That would be,
that was what we called, but it looks like Suzanne Birt lies one. Confirmed by Heather. 1-3 right now. The problem with this shot is that they're kind of hitting the stone, bringing it into play. And Suzanne's just trying to make the hit on as well. I almost like either a draw around the center guard here. Force the action to the middle. Why first and third somewhere? The other option is if you are going to play the hit, you almost want to play the nose hit or maybe a slight roll inside. And what you would do then is then Suzanne couldn't come back and hit that stone and be shot. Made a better shot than that, though. Absolute pistol, rolled it right to the top of the forefoot. Thank you. the rule they're implying is to get behind their own, even if you get behind over there, they
taking out and they make
just took off on them. Just a bit of a late swooping call there. They were waiting on and off, and then all of a sudden it broke on them, and then we have a hit for two here.
Give me a little bit of it.
An update on the men's game. James Grattan scored two in the first, and Peter Birt has come back with one in the second inning. Grattan up 2-1 after two ends.
Looking
makes a play around the guard. Got it. Shot going with a shooter hole. It does. Two on the board for Suzanne Birt here in the second end. They square the game at deuces. Smith-Dacey will take the hammer 2-3. Yeah, both these teams are coming out to play. They really are playing a bit of an aggressive game and getting a feel for the ice. And I think games like this, they aren't, you know, they're great to win. You always want to win a match. This is the opportunity for you to get on this ice, play aggressively, learn the nuances of curl and break and your teammates. And then when the games really count and you need to play offense, you've got that in the back
pocket.
I think sometimes when you actually go and watch the body games, especially early in the week, and you see some of the games and teams are missing by a lot. You know, you get open hits that are flashed by 6 inches to a foot. You know, you get draws that are off by a lot. And I don't think it has nearly as much to do with the talent and skill of the players as it is to do with the fact that they're basically stepping onto a surface that they don't play on all year. And it can make you look foolish, very evil.
That's right. There's no, women don't play, even the veterans don't play just like surface.
Top tries to hit and roll here. That blue stone right at the top of the 12 foot is in great position for Team Birt.
Yep.
Lead stone for Team Smith-Dacey. Helen, what's Bliss's new last name? Joyce?
Joyce.
She got married this summer?
Absolutely. Jill got married this summer, too.
Yeah, I know Jill.
Yeah, both of them got married this summer.
So it's Joyce.
Bliss was a contract, right?
Yeah.
Right, she was a contract.
I still have her as thumbs up, so that's why I'm sure her jersey's different. Michelle McQuaid attempting to draw around top cover. Just slips on through the rings.
Right now. Apparently, Bliss got married this summer. She was good. Really, I knew her father really well. He's a real character. You know, like the bride and I couldn't tell her who he was. He was a legendary, big tiger boy.
It's good to have confidence.
Well, Dickie has confidence. He has 7 grand finals. About 3 of them in Nova Scotia and 4 of them in New Brunswick, and he's won them one time. His father was the lead, I believe, right now. Winning effort.
Wade coming back after sliding through on that first one.
Well, for the year off last year, Phil Recreation,
gets it by the back stone. The problem is, though, I think she probably would have rather kicked the back stone and moved it off the forefoot.
She's still looking at dodging. World on the shot.
That's in a good spot.
Great spot, yeah.
Nothing's more scary than trying to throw guards when you've got the hammer.
And this is
I'm surprised by this call. I don't like this call at all.
Well, the guys are going to play the chip.
The chip or draw around right on the sea line, Barry, around the guard and the rock and top of the 8 foot, and now your guard is in the way.
That's right. Well, that's what I mean. They lined up with playing the chip right after this.
A lot of things you could do here. You could come down, try and get to the inside. Same shot you just played last time. The other option is, you could try and put it through the hole, and if you take the back, your back one on the back of the fourth foot, that's perfectly fine.
Yeah.
Now, where it ended up, it's not as bad. Better there than our longer guard that they can't use.
I think
they call him the draw around here. Drop it right on the button. Got the back. They can leave the front stone on an angle. Great shot. I think the thing they're forgetting about is if they hit that yellow stone card on the left side, the yellow's going to hit.
Yellow's going to hit. Weird spot. They come to spot and they're down to you. And now you are going to hit. The longer the road and the longer the road.
Even catching it right on the nose, it'll be your stone that you're going to be. So on the next one, you can always use it. It worked out. They caught it thinner than they planned to. And the yellow moves across the top.
Yeah.
Blank end in the men's final.
The hammer up 2.
The hammer up 2-1 after 3 ends. Suzanne Birt Stone here in the third end. She's 100% committed to this shot here. Come off and come down. And it looks like Smith-Dacey lying shot now.
I think the longest
I'll be the case if they try to play the run back in the game.
I think what Suzanne's looking at
here is just to follow down and force Heather to just get her run. Probably the safe call there. There's a lot of things that could go wrong if you play that run back. So you could get shot and make the point here. That was probably the safest thing in life. She comes right down to the face and kills her a lot. She might be able to get shot. My question now is, throw some weight through that hole with the out turn. Can you come off your own just on the side of the forefoot and spin onto the button? Now the shot that they are playing, yeah, just kind of come around, catch the paper by the two stones on the top of the ball. Last stone of the third end. This is a shot you can't hurt herself, so no harm in trying it. Gonna try to get by and just catches the top. So 1 point on the board for Team Smith-Dacey here. They took a 3-2 lead into the fourth end here at the 2013 Pearl Atlantic Championship. We're streaming live from the UCI campus in Charlottetown, Prince Edward Island. Here at the Carey Complex in the Golfing Arena. My name is Jared Burt of CurlingZone.com, joined by Al Ledgerwood. Pleasure to have you today. Joining me now. You have to renegotiate that. The game is over. So this is the final game here that we'll be covering. Obviously, last game of the day. We've got a men's final going on as well. That game's wrapped. 2-1 in there into the fourth end with three stones to come. We'll give a little update as soon as we see that end coming in. And then next weekend, we'll be in Rockville, Ontario for the Shorty Jenkins Classic. We'll be streaming from an excellent event. We've got a great lineup of teams. Kevin Martin will be there, Glenn Howard will be there, Jeff Stoughton, and several more of the top ranked teams in the world. On the women's side, we've got Rachel Holman and Steve Burnett both in the field as well.
Wow,
be sure to tune in, check out. We'll have our schedule posted on CurlingZone.com at some point midweek once we determine our game and matchup. But the event's been great. They've lined up 2-2 for us to keep it from an amazing game. So late in the week, we've got a game between Kevin Hart and Nicholas Reed. The world champions, those two when they play each other, are always exciting.
I'm good feeling going into it.
Yeah, lots of rock to play, lots to think about. Both teams are making a lot of beautiful shots. That one just gets by. Right to the back of the forefoot. Now, when you're in the team without him, that's a great spot. Because you compress the forefoot, you make scoring, you compress the scoring area. So if you're Suzanne Bird in that situation, and that rock is tight around and you're going to be behind the forefoot, you want to take that as deep as possible. So that when the other team freezes to it, it doesn't squeeze down the scoring area. Suzanne lies on the face of the stone thrown by Hunter. Now, quickly fill out for a third. Let Comstock now Joyce come down to the face of it. And if she can weld one on there, the button will be very small. Give it a little lean. This certainly changed from a television standpoint in that way. The rock is playing out. It's very much turned the game into a game you can watch as an armchair guest and really analyze the situation and what shots they should play and stuff like that. Absolute fury thrown there by Michelle McQuaid.
young guy there who is not there.
Yeah, the stories were so amazing about the game. I was just talking about the sportsmanship of the game. Things that happened in some of the provincial was just crazy. And he was digging up old wires for things. And he was coming down to the car steel and everything. And how the game really evolved over time as well. I came to understand why Ontario is the way it is with its approach to play down and money in the game. Whereas Western Canada was very much about, you know, King's Glove, play surprises, big purses. And there was a vote in the 70s where the rules in Ontario were $250, you couldn't win more than $250 as a player. Or you'd be considered a professional, and you were not allowed to enter play-down. We saw teams out of Ontario turn down big prizes. They'd win these tournaments, which is the BBC Classic, all these clubs that were in the world, and they couldn't accept the prize money because they wanted to play down. In Western Canada, they didn't have these rules in their province. It was the cars, cash prizes. And it came very close in a vote at the CPA level at the point of the 70s where the entire Dominion almost went down. And that would have, you know, it would have really changed the game. I think we've seen a lot more of a professional throwing league and an amateur throwing league nowadays. I think it would have also diminished what the Briar was in that case as well.
Wow, the
a car steal. Everybody gets a car.
Everybody
gets a
car. A guy who was a nervous car and he owned a car dealer. So, he never got out of Saskatchewan. He still was driving my new girl pocket like myself.
That'd be, who's that, Merv Man? Yeah.
He absolutely dominated his car steal. His car steal was just a couple of people like to go.
Let's listen in here as they talk about this shot.
Thank you.
There's a yellow one next in line that's just fighting the back of the button.
yellow birthstone on the button. There's a danger stone on the top of the button that looks like that we believe is counting seconds. Another stone in front of that one, and then the yellow stone you see right on top there. I don't think there's anything good that can come in the hands right now. Often for the back one, I like the call. You know, it's being proactive, trying to make something happen rather than. Sometimes you need to throw that card and hope they move, but you can't expect that. This level, you need to always expect your opposition to move their card. Interesting.
Thank you.
another end here. Lots of rocks to play.
This is a good one now.
Well, I think I can get though. I don't have to get it. The situation is good. Angles are bad. And it's shaping up for us. I'm not sure if I'm going to have to deal. So, I can deal with that.
We've got a couple of comments in that chat window already. 88267. Tim Gates watching from Omaha, Nebraska. Curling Zone fan. And then Brett McDougall watching from Halifax. So, shout out to all our fans. Thank you for checking us out. Just one of the two stones.
I apologize for the
You know what, every once in a while you know when you did something wrong. And I think that's, as a player, now Heather knows that Jill made a mistake, and Heather can give Bill the same ice there. She doesn't have to change it, she doesn't have to adjust the ice based on it. All the great teams take responsibility for their mistakes, and it has to be a better team. Yeah, sometimes it's, there's a balance, right? The management style of a team leader. Sometimes some of them are strict and demanding, and some are more of a nurturing kind of style. And at some point, you really got to look at yourself. What do they need to do? There are players out there who they need the proverbial kick in the ass to get out there and make shots and motivate them and drive them. Well, there's players who also will call the other way, where that'll just bring them down and will push them. The type who needs a little bit more encouragement and positive reinforcement for the past. And it's really about reading people and psychology and
interaction.
Yeah, you can't always feel the same way with players on the team. And you know what? Sometimes we see that it comes off when we fall as viewers of these teams. We see them for a while, as bodies, as riders, and stuff like that. And all these armchair fans like to say, well, that's just being mean to this player, or this player talks too much, or stuff like that. But that's the dynamic of their team. If we're watching them for the first time at a ride or a body or a world championship, obviously it's a successful yes.
See
throwing guards on ice like this certainly isn't the easiest thing.
Thank you.
Okay. Then we'll talk about junior.
you decide that you're going to make it and break on one solar or one large rock, sometimes the second last thing of the filling game is the one that you really don't want to play. A lot of good teams, a lot of good players over the years, great players that are always finally get their lives done and be able to execute. And I'm not sure that these two second teams are working on great. Basically, the play game.
I'm not going to like this one.
I don't know, that's why I'm better than that.
It's human nature to see something happen and think, you know, this is what always happens. Like flipping a coin, shifting them up heads or tails, so 50% of the time. And, you know, you flip a coin 10 times and it comes up heads 10 times in a row. You know, you say to yourself, well, tails do. Or maybe heads do not.
It's not
there. Yeah, but every time you flip that coin, it's still just 50%. There's no relationship between the previous odds and the previous results to work with the odds.
I would also remind you that the coins have no memory.
Like casinos make money because people are fooled by that.
Well, here's an interesting situation here. If you're down, there's a lot of expensive things. You're looking at the property. Around the home, on purpose.
There must be an opportunity here. Because there's a gift around the other side. Being a lefty, that side would actually be slightly easier. If you can draw this around to the back of the wheel, but even back of the 8-foot area, it's just going to move a little bit more. Especially if it's just a little bit too heavy.
I think
when you're talking about this team and Heather especially, I think they've struggled with placement of stone. You know, drawing T line or even behind the T line in the 8-foot on the other side would be a great spot. I'm not sure they'll struggle for placement on that. Just made the shot too.
Junior Olympian.
Yep. We've got a lot. We've got that double circle, and
I think part of it too is that at the junior age, there's a very level playing field. Most of these young fellows come up through the club to club system to play in regular club fields and they can compete amongst their peers. And you're seeing a lot of these young players from the Maritimes to come up through the testing system of the players in Alberta and Ontario. And when they get to that top level, they can compete. Sometimes you see that happen at the adult level, and this is where a event like this will hopefully start to benefit the guys at West, who are in Calvin, and play elite events all the time. Like Brad Fisher, who put in a lot of money and a lot of time to just stay competitive, and much more so than anybody out west who is in Ontario, the sacrifices that he makes his career, his family, and all that stuff. Especially when I'm traveling from Newfoundland, you have a day. And when you're looking at a team like Suzanne Birt, coming out of junior, who had the talent to be one of the best players in the country around the world, sometimes life gets in the way I'm looking forward to seeing this third team in Toronto on Thanksgiving weekend. They're coming out to the Seagulls Toronto Tigers. This thing to ever end, I think. have a final in the men's game. Peter Burgess steals two in the 8th and wins it.
That's a bit of an upset. Real upset.
Great throw by Heather Smith-Dacey.
That's a good option.
That header is kind of like that. drove here from London, Ontario.
Did you?
Yeah. And Jesse, who and his buddy are out shooting all kinds of tourist stuff around the island, and they're doing a YouTube and a web travel look.
I dropped my son off at the University of Toronto last week and drove back through Rockdale, through that country, and then I went down to Vermont. Beautiful down here.
Oh, yeah, it's great. It's a great drive.
It is a great drive.
Yeah, careful, too. That's the website.
Okay.
You should check it out.
I will.
Give me one of my cards, too.
Yeah, give me one of your cards. She wasn't falling off that arc.
No, that curls up, and she had plenty of weight.
Yeah.
Like, I think she just missed the back.
Yeah.
But if that curls another inch, I think she makes it.
That's good. Well, we'll see you in the spring then.
All right, take care.
Okay.
All right, tear down time. I got to.
Yeah.
Open for 100.